Hello everyone, I'm Mike Guidry, Curator of Public Art at the University of Houston System, and welcome back to another episode of Art Walks. Today's topic is perception, which is the ability to see, hear, or become aware of something through the senses. Today we're going to look at two sculptures, one by Linda Howard and another by Charles Jenever, where the viewer must use their senses to understand the sculpture while having their perception and first impressions challenged in the process. Let's start with Roundabout by Linda Howard. As you approach the sculpture, you may notice first, it's a large scale, occupying a lot of space, but also has a transparent quality due to the aluminum coloration and spacing of the forms. You may also see volume, mass, and depth. The aluminum tubes are stacked vertically and horizontally, and it appears to be curved or have a cube form depending on your perspective. Any way you approach a sculpture, you are fooled by it. Move around it, and it transforms. It's fascinating to me that this complex form was created from repeated use of the same shape, a 4x4 inch by 16 foot tube. At one viewpoint, it spirals and turns in and back out from a single point. You experience the triangular form and the cube walking the circumference of the sculpture. It's essentially three planes, one vertical and two diagonal, but it reads as something far more complex. The sculpture does not reveal itself in one glance. The viewer has to discover all these visual elements. And now we're at Troika by Charles Jenever. I found a great quote from him that says, "You can't understand any of my work until you circle it." So that's what we're gonna do. Troika is a play on perception and reality through its geometric form. As the viewer approaches the work, from one perspective, it looks like two intersecting squares. And as you move around the sculpture, a cube is revealed and appears to flatten and expand in space. The result is a complex work that challenges perspective while making us think about how things are often not as they first appear. Moving around it, you see the folding and unfolding of planes and form, open and closed elements, voids and negative space, illusion of perspective, and the appearance of depth and dimension are all intentional manipulations of the artist. Because of all the significant advancements of the 20th century, these artists have learned to look at their world in a far more complex way than their ancient ancestors ever did. I hope you enjoyed this episode today, and to learn more about our collection, please visit our website and follow us on social media, and I hope to see you next week for another episode of Art Walks with me, Mike Guidry.